silk.
We got the 1290 Super Adventure. Let's see. Ready to race.
Hold those sleeves down for me, okay?
Good? You good, man?
Good. Right. This place is nice. Reminds me of the Tiger 1200. Let's see. What's this? Okay. Rider mode. Board. Confirm. Where's the back button? That's the back button. I'm sports mode now. Alright. I don't know if I'm gonna regret this. Alright. Let's see how it rides. It's not decent tall bike. There we go, we're green. Gear picks right back up. Nice strong motor. Supposedly the 1290 has the self-canceling directionals, so that's going to be good. I had to change the mic again before on this helmet because the mic fell out while I was riding before. So the last ride on the Indian is shit. But what are you gonna do? I think we're gonna make a left here. Open it up. Trying to figure out where do I turn my brights off. definitely goes. Got some nice power. Handles real nice. I like it. Reminds me of the Tiger. Probably is in the same price range too. Wind is not too bad actually, doesn't hit you that bad. But we are also not going that fast. Would love to see how it feels on our way. That's curve. Yeah, I think I like the Tiger better. I think the Tiger was also a more smoother ride. But this is the R, so suspension I think is probably more stiffer. This also has knobbies on it. Not really a street tire. I don't remember what the Tiger had on it, but I think I like the Tiger better. But for that price range, I can get a bike I actually really would enjoy for fucking like $8,000 less. So I don't know how much this one is, but lost someone already. Oh, fuck. I'll be honest, this ride sucks. I want to go. I want to test the limits of these bikes. And riding like this, you can't. You can't, you know, test the acceleration. You can't, you know, it's a nice looking bike, but I want to really test it. I do like to displays. Now what they're doing with these new displays, it's just amazing, you know. Any, doesn't matter how, but you will see this, you know, in any weather condition. Play with the features, you know. I can see there's two knobs on the side of the windshield, so you can make the windshield higher or lower. So display is good. I'm in sports mode, so the bike actually goes pretty good. So, but you can't really try right now because this is like so slow, so slow. But what are you gonna do? Still nice ride. I do think the Triumph Tiger is more comfortable. I'm not aware if this has quick shift or not. I'll have to look at it when I get off. But I know the Tiger had that, and that was really cool. Exhaust sounds okay. I'm sure if you put an aftermarket on, it would sound a lot better. Seat, I don't know. You know, this kid said, oh, he liked this one, the sitting position, the best. But yes, my, you know, my knees are on the tank, like hugging it really nice, but you see, it's not fucking comfortable at all. Handling, yeah, it handles nice. But it's definitely a stiffer ride. Definitely a stiffer ride. Let's go. This is where the lady wrecked like 2 years ago. Put the Indian out of the ditch. Found the light button. Then again, yeah, high beams on. I don't know how to play around with this fucking button, so I'm gonna wait. I do enjoy this sit up straight bikes more now these days than when I used to have the sports bikes, always leaning forward. Does that cruise now? No cruise. Nope. I don't know. What the fuck is this? What is this? No. I don't know what that is. Oh, that was, is that my lap timer or something maybe? I don't know. Alright. Made that right turn. Bike is fucking tall. Tall as a fucker.